Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off this video, we have a couple of bits of information, starting with this article recently posted. It says, AST Space Mobile, the company building the first and only space-based cellular broadband network accessible directly by standard mobile phones, today announced an agreement with SpaceX for the launch of its next prototype spacecraft, Blue Walker 3. Scott Manley posted a tweet saying, I looked at the orbits of just one batch of Starlink satellites and you can see them starting as a single block, eventually splitting into three planes while losing a couple along the way. Musk responded with, orbital precession takes a long time. With Starship and Starlink version 2, hopefully we can direct inject to target orbit. There was a series of tweets posted by SpaceX. The first of these says, crew-free astronauts visited NASA Kennedy this week for emergency preparedness training. Then, in another tweet, they posted a picture with the caption, the Inspiration 4 crew was also in Florida this week for training ahead of their flight in September. Then finally, related to astronauts, they also posted more than 20 astronauts from around the world are currently going through SpaceX human spaceflight training. As you may already know, over in Boca Chica, SpaceX stacked the 9th and final integration tower level during the week. Tank Watchers posted a tweet with a video of SpaceX stacking the 9th level of the integration tower. It says, SpaceX teams have stacked the last section of the orbital tower. The tower is now complete and stands 469 feet tall. Musk responded with, congrats SpaceX tower team and supporting contractors. Musk was asked a question about the catching mechanism. The tweet says, is there a render of how the catch of the booster will work? Musk responded and said, we'll post once we have a decent simulation. Our first design will probably be far from the bullseye. As mentioned in the last video, the orbital launch table and GSE-5 tank were rolled to the launch site. Michael Baylor posted a tweet of the orbital launch table being prepared to lift onto the mount. Musk responded and said, stage 0, which is everything needed to launch and catch the rocket, is at least as hard as the booster or ship. Musk posted some cool shots of the orbital launch table being lifted. He captioned it with, Starbase is moving at warp 9. Somebody responded and asked, Elon, how much does that part of the launch table weigh? Musk responded with, 370 tons. Chris Burgin also posted a tweet of the orbital launch table as it made contact with the launch mount base. Musk responded and said, needs to be level and match booster fittings. We will find out on around Tuesday. Work continues on the mystery yellow pipe structure. Here's a view of the mystery structure being worked on near the production site. This really cool shot was posted on Twitter by everyday astronaut of Musk taking a picture of a nose cone with a load of heat shield tiles. Musk responded to the tweet and said, hadn't showered in several days. We are going hardcore with Starbase Surge. Elon Musk posted this amazing inside shot of the aft section for Super Heavy Booster 4, I believe. Musk tweeted it saying, completing feed system for 29 Raptor rocket engines on Super Heavy Booster. Somebody responded and said, take a look at this for scale. This is huge. I was able to find 23 employees inside. Musk then responded with, yeah, SpaceX team are cranking hard. Everyday astronaut tweeted about Musk's tweet with, oh baby, look at that spaghetti of plumbing. This whole thing is just crazy. I can't wait to see the full stack. Musk responded and said, and that's just the primary fuel lines. The maze of secondary plumbing and wiring is our greatest concern. He then responded to his own tweet with, Raptor version 2 is a major improvement in simplification while also increasing thrust from approximately 185 tons to approximately 230 tons. Long-term goal is engine cost below $1,000 per ton of thrust. Scott Manley responded to Elon Musk's original tweet with, remember, rockets are a transportation system based on a series of tubes. Musk responded with, so many tubes. This tweet was posted about an article from the GAO. It says, Blue Origin and Dynetics protest which contested NASA's awarding of the Human Landing System contract to SpaceX has been rejected. Christian Davenport also posted a tweet on this saying, HLS stays with SpaceX, statement on Blue Origin Dynetics decision. US GAO in denying the protests, GAO first concluded that NASA did not violate procurement law or regulation when it decided to make only one award. A brand new vacuum Raptor was spotted unloaded at Starbase. Crews continue to work on ground support equipment tanks in the production yard. As well as being rolled out, the GSC-5 tank was lifted into place recently. The aft flap mounting mechanism was installed onto the Starship 20 body. The Starship 20 nose cone has now been stacked with the barrel section. The Super Heavy Booster 4 methane section was seen being stacked. Booster 4's methane stack was moved out of the high bay for something special. That something special was the picture you can see on the left in this tweet. The first grid fin has now been installed. This tweet was posted asking, looks like non-folding grid fins on Booster 4, guessing this is a case of best part is no part. Is this accurate, Elon Musk? Musk responded and said yes. Somebody posted a tweet about people who think SpaceX don't know what they are doing with the grid fins. Musk responded with, indeed, grid fin designs clearly work, but do they maximize payload? Good chance that they do not. Something with much more drag to reduce terminal velocity and so reduce landing propellant might have better performance. Not sure. Potential future optimization. This other Booster 4 section was spotted sitting outside waiting for stacking. Musk was also asked about a payload for the first orbital attempt of Starship and Super Heavy. Elon Musk responded and said, a wheel of cheese. One final thing to take a look at, like usual for our Sunday video, is the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to thank Mary or Boca Chica Girl, who is out in Boca Chica constantly filming the activity going on there. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.